Man, like a needle in a groove, some things just go better together, and probably always will. Like a cup of coffee and a sunrise, Sunday drive, some time to kill. What's the point of this old guitar if it ain't got no strings? Well, pouring your heart into a song that you ain't gonna sing. It's a match made up in heaven, like good old boys and beer. And it means long as you're right here. Sometimes we're oil and water, but I wouldn't have it any other way. And if I'm being honest, your first and my last name. We'll just sound better together, and probably always win. Like a cup of coffee and a sunrise, Sunday drives and time to kill. What's the point of this old guitar if it ain't got no strings? Or pouring your heart into a song that you ain't gonna sing. It's a match made up in heaven, like good old boys and beer. And as long as you're right here. And as long as you're right here.
Thank you, everybody. Please be seated. Dan and Laura, welcome to your wedding ceremony. Standing here with all of your loved ones in this beautiful countryside. To find someone to marry is a privilege and is to be celebrated. So take a moment to just take it all in together. In many ways, you will step away from today's ceremony feeling that very little has changed. You already have a history together. You already live together and share your lives. However, a wedding is a deliberate and a public act. And by making your vows out loud, you are also saying to each other and to everyone here that your union is important, that you are choosing each other, and that you want everyone else to know that this is your person. Now, all love stories start somewhere, and this one started one thirsty Thursday. At this time, it had become a bit of a ritual on a Thursday to pop out to the local and meet some work associates Laura knew through working in haulage at her old job at Radnor Hills. On this occasion, Laura spotted an unfamiliar face outside on the terrace by himself and asked her friend Tony who it was. It turned out to be none other than Dan, who'd only recently moved to Knighton from Ryder and was working with Tony, so didn't know anybody much apart from him. Intrigued, she went over to say hello, and they ended up having a very nice chat. As time passed, they would occasionally chat through social media, finding things in common, including a love of walking, nature, music, and dogs. By accident, they found out they were living close by to each other. And being in a small town, Dan would sometimes go walking out with Walter the dog in the hope that maybe he might bump into Laura on his travels. Oftentimes, he'd catch sight of Laura at the other side of the street or passing in the car and would occasionally smile and wave to each other. But they didn't actually meet again in person properly for a while after that first meeting, that first Thursday night. When they did finally meet again, with the use of Walter the dog as Dan's wingman, they both realised how much they clicked and that perhaps there was something here. Their relationship began and it quickly blossomed into something special. It wasn't long before they moved in together, beginning a life together as a couple in earnest. Both of them enjoyed spending time together, working on joint projects, as well as going on lots of excursions, camping, climbing mountains, sea cliff climbing, caving, and taking long walks. In fact, there are over 100 photographs of Dan and Laura's shared adventures on display in the restaurant to look at over dinner, as they explored the beautiful countryside, sometimes with Walter, their much beloved golden wonder. Since moving to their countryside abode, they've worked on it together, doing DIY in the garden, as well as other gardening projects and trips. It's often luck that leads us to that right person at the right time. And here is a poem called Maybe, about finding that person for you, which I will read now. Maybe. Maybe we're supposed to meet the wrong people before we meet the right one. So when they finally arrive, we're truly grateful for the gift we have been given. Maybe it's true that we don't know what we've lost until we lose it. But it's also true that we don't know what we're missing until it arrives. Maybe the happiest of people don't have the best of everything, but make the best of everything that comes their way. Maybe the best kind of love is the kind where you sit on the sofa together, not saying a word, and walk away feeling like it was the best conversation you ever had. Maybe once in a lifetime, you find someone who not only touches your heart, but also your soul. Someone who loves you, for who you are, and not what you could be. And maybe the art of true love is not about finding the perfect person, but about seeing an imperfect person perfectly. Now, after living together for a while, it was time to look to the future. Both Dan and Laura wanted to get married at some point, and so Dan, ever practical, bought a ring sizer. Once he knew the right size and had secretly bought a ring, it was time to find the right moment to propose. Dan booked them a trip to a log cabin in the woods near Beulah to mark their anniversary. Finally, after 6 stressful weeks of having to hide the ring in the house, Dan had his moment. First night of the trip, he and Laura had been out for an Indian meal to celebrate. And once they got back to the cabin, he sent her out of the room while he prepared a so-called anniversary surprise for her. When she was allowed back in, fairy lights were on, and the wood burner was lit, and the box with the ring was sitting on the coffee table. Speechless at first, of course Laura said yes, although not without crying. Laura and Dan. When I asked you what you loved about each other, Laura, you talked about how caring, loving, and kind Dan is. You say that he brings you a sense of calm and steadiness, and you both share a very similar outlook on life. You love that he isn't afraid to say nice things, and you appreciate how Dan always treats you as an equal. Dan, you talked about how much you enjoy Laura's company, having someone in your life that shares the same taste for adventure, enjoys working on joint projects, and sharing your time and interests together. You say that you like everything about her and that she is easy to get on with. Together, you love each other and feel that you have found someone special who will support you in your endeavors, someone who accepts you as you are, and someone you can build a life with. You feel you have a shared idea of what your future together will look like, and feel that you are ready to be committed to each other officially. Marriage feels like the right next step, offering stability and certainty and the ability to plan long term together, as well as a celebration of your relationship so far. You feel that you have a good life together along with Walter. And I checked, and he tells me it's good with him too. Now, getting married is a binding commitment, but marriage and love are not fixed states. The best marriages are ones where each partner understands that they have an active role to play, creating a partnership between you both, allowing each other to be themselves, but also working and playing together as a team. As Ursula Le Guin says, love doesn't just sit there like a stone. It has to be made like bread, remade all the time, made new. There will be ebb and flow, and the need for tenderness, commitment, forgiveness, and mutual respect, as well as love, now and into the future. The marriage that you build together will need to stand you in good stead for whatever lies ahead. For each of you enter it individually and can break it at any time. So take it seriously and cherish it. So today, surrounded by all of your loved ones, you're going to make your wedding vows to each other. These vows are an affirmation of your relationship so far, your shared history and values. They are also words of intent, because a marriage is an ongoing intentional act, and having to take the time to think about what you want to say to your partner in this moment and what you're promising them means that you are going into this with your eyes and your hearts open. And know that you are starting on your journey together from a place of love and of honesty. You are accompanying your vows with a ring exchange. A wedding is largely about symbols. Symbols are important and helpful because they make an idea and a value concrete and physical, something we can see and touch. They're helpful because they serve as a powerful reminder of a time and a place and a memory. And to show that you mean what you've said to each other, you will each offer the other a ring as a reminder of the promises that you've said today. A reminder that wherever you go and whatever you are doing, you are deeply loved, and that there is a place and a person whom you can call home, even when you are apart. Traditionally, in this country, a couple exchanges wedding rings, for like the love they represent, a circle has no end. And hands in marriage are important, and we wear wedding rings on our third finger because the Romans believed that this finger was connected directly to the heart. This may not be strictly correct, but the sentiment stands true, a heart connection surrounded by your partner's love. Andy, if you're ready, if you could bring up the rings, thank you. I'm going to take your flowers off.
Is she going to have to get married?
So, Dan, I'm going to ask you to say your vows to Laura first. Do you want to stand and face each other?
Laura, I asked you to marry me because I've never felt such a strong connection to another person. I love how you are caring and considerate, and your inquisitive and encouraging nature. I feel like there isn't anything we can't achieve, and I'm looking forward to all our future escapades. With this ring, I promise you'll never have to face the world alone. You are my every dream come true, and I can't wait for the reality we get to build together. I promise to keep our lives exciting, adventurous, and full of passion. I promise to be there for you whenever you need me. I promise to make you happy, make you laugh, and to always be there for you. You are the love of my life. I promise to adore you, cherish you, and respect you forever.
Laura's ring and place it on the tip of her finger. Repeat after me. I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As a symbol.
As a symbol.
Of the promises I've made to you.
Of the promises I've made to you.
Laura, please answer. I will treasure it always.
Okay.
Now slide the ring onto her finger. Now, Laura, when you're ready, say your vows to Dan. I have a tissue. Promise it's clean.
Sorry. Met in life and all the places that you've been, somehow, some way, it's led you here today with me on our wedding day. So that day that I said, Tony, who's your friend? I'll never regret, because I met a man who lives simply, loves generously, cares deeply and speaks kindly. You're so patient with me and you treat me like an equal. You do everything to make me feel like I'm enough. You bring out the best version of myself. You make me belly laugh until I can't breathe. And ironically, despite leading me into caves or up cliff bases where you scared me half to death, you make me feel safe. You strongly advocate living in the moment, so life's never boring, I can tell you that. Other attributes include our shared love of extra thick gravy like proper northerners, spontaneous off-road adventures in the truck, introducing me to puddings after every meal, and being able to reach the top shelf. The saying goes that the greatest happiness in life is to love and be loved. But you would probably argue that it would be to own a Scania V8 7-centre. But I guess we can't have everything. Although I can't give you that. Today, in front of our friends and family, I want to make these promises to you. I promise to never take our time together for granted and vow to make the most of every day that we share together. I pledge to treat you as my best friend and equal. I'll keep my heart open to you today, tomorrow, and always. I promise to put all my efforts into strengthening our marriage and giving you the best version of myself. And because words alone can't do it, I promise to show you for the rest of my life how much I love you. Today, I choose to spend the rest of my life with you because you make me happier than I could have ever imagined, and I feel more loved than I ever thought was possible. Thank you for making this the happiest day of my life so far.
Laura, if you take Dan's ring and place it on the tip of his finger and repeat after me. I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As a symbol.
As a symbol.
Of the promises I've made to you.
Of the promises I've made to you.
Dan, please answer. I will treasure it always.
I will treasure it always.
Now slide the ring down onto his finger. And so, you have both said your marriage vows to each other, and you have exchanged rings as a permanent symbol of your promises that you have made. Therefore, it gives me great pleasure to announce that in front of everyone here, you are now a married couple, husband and wife, wife and husband to each other, together. And you should definitely celebrate this moment with a kiss. So congratulations, and that brings our ceremony to a close. I want to wish you both much love and much happiness in the future as you build your new marriage step by step and day by day. All that remains is to get the celebration started. So you're going to lead the way. Everyone, please stand and get ready to join Laura and Dan on the terrace for drinks. So I give you the newlyweds, Dan and Laura. Let's give them a round of applause.